Walked 12 batters in the game. CRSB would take advantage of that. In fact, they took big time advantage. They were up 18-14 going into the final inning, and that's the way it would stay, because check out this defensive gem. CRSB catches the ball, brings it into the relay man. They think they got him at first, and they throw it into second. That's how the game ended. CRSB defeats the defending champs, 18-14. Senior Airman Jason Phelps, Eiffel Sports.
Brigadier General Gene Renouart relinquishes his command of the 52nd Fighter Wing tomorrow, but before he leaves, the commander has one last message for Team Eiffel.
The past 2 years with the 52nd Fighter Wing has been a roller coaster ride that's been unimaginable. Such great highs, so few lows, it's really been a superb opportunity for our family. We want to thank each of you for the great support you've given us. Jill and I will always have a special place in our heart for Team Eiffel. As we prepare to leave, we wish you all the best, and we hope that our Air Force brings us together again sometime down the road. Godspeed, good luck to all of you, and here's my way to say thank you to the 52nd Fighter Wing, Team Eiffel Warriors.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. American, where at least I know I'm free, and I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, well, it's right in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, American, where at least I know I'm free, and I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
And that's our report. Have a good evening. Detachment 17. General Newton talks about his trip during an interview with Eiffel News.
It's great to be in Europe again and to be here at the Fighting 52nd. You know, we in the training business, we are responsible for providing the kind of resources that's needed to get the mission accomplished out here in the field. That's the reason I'm here, to see how well we're doing. I'm getting some feedback on that, and it appears that we're doing reasonably well. There's always room for improvement, and we're looking for those opportunities to improve. so that we continue with our United States Air Force being the best Air Force in the world.
He went on to talk about some of the major issues affecting today's Air Force, one of which is retention.
We've certainly seen some change in the retention rates now across the board. That's making a difference whether we're talking about our enlisted or our officers. And there are certainly several factors that drive that. We are living in a very, very robust economy that gives our folks many, many options to decide on other things that they might would like to go and do. And so that's impacting us. We in the uniform has largely been responsible as well for the robustness of our economy because we've helped to create those stable and secure environments around the world. And so we are going through this cycle, and we go through these cycles every so often, and this is just our time now. We'll work our way out of this and come out on the other side.
General Newton plans to visit many European bases during his trip. Some English cadets were in the Eiffel for Exercise Southern Tower, which is their last military exercise before graduation. As Airman First Class UL Line 1 tells us, the 52nd Fighter Wing helped make their experience a rewarding one.
More than 260 British cadets from the Royal Military Academy of Sandhurst came to Manderscheid, Germany to literally field test their combat skills in Exercise Southern Tower. 52nd Fighter Wing Force Protection members and a British Gurkha platoon acted as aggressors during the exercise.
It's a great time for us. Hopefully it's a great time for them, just getting different types of weapons out here, different forces besides just the Gurkhas that they're playing against that they normally use. So hopefully it's a great training for them and good training for us also.
Right, 20 platoon, we're gonna get up and we're gonna push forward to the edge of the tree line because they're now firing over on the other side of the track.
Exercise Southern Tower included more than just British cadets and security forces members. 9 cadets from the United States Military Academy also joined in on the action.
Enemy just in front of me! Enemy!
The enemy before they could deploy with the Sandhurst cadets for Southern Tower, they trained on British weapons and radios used in the exercise.
Where the tactics are real similar, actually. The weapon systems are a little different, but I've definitely learned a lot about the different ways of communicating in the field and how different countries operate. So it's been great.
Although the British and American armies have different ways of doing things, the West Point cadets seem to adjust well.
Yeah, they fitted in very, very well, and they've just got on with it. And that, you can't ask more than that, can you? And watching them fighting through woods and through bunkers over the last couple of days, they're doing very well.
The West Point cadets traveled to the United Kingdom following the two-week exercise for some rest and recuperation before heading back to the States. Airman First Class Joel Leinwand, Air Force News, Manderscheid, Germany.
In tonight's Focus on the Force, AFIS Chief of Operations, Mr. Mike...